regarding transportation, looking at WestJet and Air Canada, I'm wondering your level of frustration and what moves are being made for Air Canada not following in the footsteps of WestJet and taking people's names, numbers, being more proactive.
Well, a high degree of frustration. And again, that when Minister Dix, Dr. Henry and I get together to discuss the range of issues before us in terms of advice from public health, in terms of how we implement healthcare policy across the province, my responsibility is to take all of that advice and find solutions. And we have been working very cooperatively with the federal government. As you know, I seem to say this at every one of my weekly availabilities, that we have a strong partner in Ottawa, but there are some issues that just seem almost incomprehensible. We had some challenges early on when it came to correctional facilities, federal correctional facilities. It took a lot of time to get what we agreed, the three of us and the team of health care professionals, a lot of time to get to what were pretty simple solutions. Similarly, when it comes to letting the province know who's on a plane and where they're sitting and who's beside them, WestJet can figure it out. Other carriers can figure it out. Why Air Canada seems to have a challenge with this is a mystery to me. Again, this is largely a federal responsibility, and I know that I've spoken directly to the PM about this, and he is seized with the challenge. And rather than focusing on encouraging people to get out of their cars on the car deck for the trip from Swartz Bay to Pender Island, I would prefer that the Transportation Canada officials were getting us the information we need so we can protect British Columbians and keep them safe.